you're that cute little pet. Now, if your pet has the habit of running, yes, and he's all packed up and ready to take a trip, like 10 million other dogs and cats across the United States, there are actually ways to keep them protected and safe in your home and in your yard. And here with the demonstration is Mariah Schuckenbrock. She's the owner of Screen Mobile of Denver. And she's going to start off with this incentive you have during Pet Month.
Correct. May is National Pet Month, and we need to keep our pets safe and secure within the perimeters of the home or outside.
Right.
So some tips that we have today, Ken, is to actually have a doghouse or shelter outside so that when they're outside in the yard, they have somewhere to go. If it's raining or storming, they have a doghouse to be in.
Because they can get scared. Loud noises, backfires. You know, we talk about it all the time.
Fourth of July
tends to freak pets out.
Oh, yes.
So that was a great tip. Another tip you had is to give them treats.
Exactly.
They're like children. They need things to do or they're going to dig and try and escape.
Right. So if you give them treats when they come in the home or when they come back into the yard, if they run away, that motivates your pet so that they know when they come home, they get a treat.
Now, one of your tips was give them a puzzle toy.
Mm-hmm.
What does that look like? Describe what a puzzle toy is, because we don't have an example here.
Okay, a puzzle toy is where you put a treat within the toy.
They have
to get it out.
Sticks of peanut butter or something.
Exactly.
All right.
And that takes a little time for them to do, so when you're running your errands or when you're at work, it keeps them occupied.
It doesn't get them bored. Now, I've had cats. I love cats. We have a dog now. I'll never forget the time I looked over and on my sliding screen door going out into the backyard, cat halfway up and turned back and looked at me like, look at me, Dad. And it drives homeowners bananas, but your company has the way to make your screens be able to handle something like that.
Correct. This screen is our pet screen, and basically it's coated with a light plastic, so when your cat claws into the screen, it doesn't rip it or it won't ruin it.
And then what's this other down here?
This is a pet grill. You put this on the outside of your screen door so that when your pet scratch to come in or out, it won't rip the screen. And this is a pet door for the pets to go in and out at their leisure. So basically you have different options to offer.
I love it. I love it, Maria, because we love our pets. We also love our houses. We need to keep everything happy and safe. You can find out more at screenmobile.com. You're waking up to Channel 2 Daybreak. We'll be right back.